Hello everybody, I'm Ralf Wiegmann from IF, and this is our second video podcast. What is good design? This question is much more difficult to answer as it was 30 years ago. Today, almost everything wants or seems to be designed. We have asked various experts during the IF Design Awards jury to share their opinion and definition with us. Let's listen to their answers and see how satisfying they are.
That's a very good question.
Oh God. I hear this question for 20 years now, I still don't have an answer.
I have absolutely no idea what good design is. I think good design is what you make it. You know, I think it's a serious question, but I think as a designer, I think most designers don't think about what good design is. Most designers do things because they believe in what they're doing. Whether or not it's good design would then be judged by others who buy it. But I think if I have to answer the question, then I'd say good design is what you make it.
Well, good design is as little design as possible. An old phrase, many, many years quoted, but still is valid. Especially now in the area of when design becomes less and less visible.
If a design looks superb and it's well controlled and well proportioned and yet it breaks, people say it's not good design, it's poor design.
Good design or brand design or experience design can go off track if it doesn't really pay attention to one, the consumer's world, but also the wider world around that. Because how I judge whether a car is designed well might be influenced by how my computer's designed. All these things in my mind connect together as an audience. I don't see the world singularly, I see it connected.
This bag, this is just a box, but they did this small click and everybody has seen it probably. But it's such a small detail and it's not expensive to make, it's very simple, but it just gives you this super nice touch to it. And that's, I mean, this is what this has been, the one that did this is my hero and I don't even know who did it.
Good design is what puts a smile on your face. It's about, it has to fulfill the function of the product, for sure. You have to be able to easily operate the product. But I think when it comes to really special product design, it needs to be either or both, educational and emotional. If you understand why something in the product is very special from an educational point of view, you love to handle and to operate it because you can feel the difference. Or if something is like involving you emotionally very much because you love to touch it, it's a special material, or the knobs have a special way of being turned. I think this gives an additional value to the product, which is also part of the design.
A good design for me is something that really appeals me, that I really got a positive feeling from, where I don't think so much about in the very first moment. You never get a second chance to make a first impression. It's exactly this kind of spirit, exactly this feeling where I got the idea, wow, there's something, even if I cannot describe it from my consciousness, but something that really, yeah, appeals me, attaches me, and get my interest.
I think if it makes you smile, and not laugh, but small smile, that's good packaging design.